Here's my honorable mention should be number 8. My wish list, don't ban Dig Through Time and Treasure Cruise. That's my wish list.
My wish is they do ban Dig Through Time and Treasure Cruise. So all right, so
we have a conflicting wish list already for honorable mention, and it's the banning or unbanning, or banning non-banning. or non-banning of Dig Through Time and Treasure Cruise. But number 8, this is because, of course, Mashi isn't here. It's not Return of Avalanche Rider, but it is the return to Zendikar.
The much predicted. We aren't supposed to return to it right now, right?
I think everybody except for Mashi is rooting against this, right?
Yeah.
Like, nobody wants to give him the pleasure of just being correct.
Yeah. I don't even know. I mean, return to... I'm not even that excited if that happens. I get, the whole point is that, I mean, the storyline is, of course, you know, Soren is going, went to the plane of Khans, found that Ugin is dead, but he wanted his help to stop the Eldrazi.
Yeah.
So.
Well, we're going to have returned to the Eldrazi or whatever. Yeah. Those are going to come back.
But they're marching on.
Yeah. But they're not on Zendikar anymore.
They moved on.
We don't have to go back to Zendikar.
The giant flies made
but the Zendikar fetch lands. No?
But we just got fetch lands.
Yeah.
Anyways,
we have Modern Masters, you know?
Yeah, Modern Masters too.
We can get fetch lands other places than Zendikar.
Yeah. That is something that... we can see upcoming. But yes, number 8, we have Return to Zendikar. Wish list 4, of course, one of our main hosts, Mashi Scanlan, the guy on the left. Coming in at number 7. We have Moto Fixes. So this is just, you know, of course, version 4 was just released, and... you know, their vision going forward is that, you know, V4 will allow them to customize Moto a lot more in the future. Mm-hmm. So obviously when it first came out, a couple of kinks, a few bugs. They're working on it slowly. Now when you thought sees them, you can see their whole hand.
She's great now.
That's huge.
It's improved. It's dramatically.
That's huge. It still takes up a little too much memory for my taste, but.
Well, there's one like customization we don't want, right? We don't want them to customize who wins the matches.
Right, right.
Which is really that's what gets me.
Yeah, you're like, I just won, damn it. Why did the other person?
Way worse is when you lose and it says that you won.
Oh,
that's
sure.
The worst. Yeah.
I'll also give an asterisk. I also would like leagues, which I think we have a good chance of getting, actually. I think we'll have leagues.
Leagues
in
is something
the next
that,
6 months.
Yeah, I mean, as long as they can handle it. I like that idea of.
That's been on the wish list for many
leagues.
Years.
On demand tournament kind of thing?
The on demand, like daily type things.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, where basically it's like you do a sealed deck, you're 0-0. All right, you won. You're 1-0. And you're 4-0,
you get 4 rounds and you rejoin.
That seems awesome.
Well, I'm hoping that's what their implementation of leagues is going to look like.
That would be awesome.
That's what everybody wants.
Yes. That way you don't
give
have to be like, oh crap, I missed the 3 o'clock standard or whatever.
Yeah.
Or hey, it's full. You know, it's like, no, you can just always play standard whenever you want.
Yep.
Yeah, and you can just play.
And you can also.
I have 15 minutes. I can play a match of Magic. You can't do that right now.
You can always stop whenever
you want.
We'll
have this soon. This will be here in the
next
6 months.
So this will be something awesome for Moto to have. And of course, also, if they can do the thing with the graveyard where the graveyard's actually showing instead of clicking, I would also like that as well. So number 7, Moto Fixes. Coming in at number 6, we have something that existed before and something that I'd like to see in the future. I don't know if we'll ever see it again, but Magic Invitationals.
These are sweet.
Wouldn't, like when I was playing and wanted to make it to the Pro Tour, I was like, man, this is like the old. This is what I want. I want to be voted in to the Magic Invitational. It seems awesome. It's kind of like combining all the sweet stuff that happens at the Community Cup and the World Championships.
Right.
Yeah.
I think we have those two now, which are actually both really cool events.
Right.
And having, you know, the benefit of playing in Worlds twice, like Worlds is awesome.
Yeah.
It's so fun just being in such a small tournament, intimate tournament, with, like, cool things going on.
Right. And they like they treat you like VIP.
Great. Oh yeah, it's great. But I actually would have more fun if it wasn't, you know,
so
a million pro points and a bunch of money on the line, but we're playing. It's like
for a magic
fun.
Card?
Yeah, that would be so sick.
Yeah.
It would be even more fun.
Right.
So I would love to see that. You know, I think it would be great.
Yeah. Thoughts?
Yeah, I wasn't around for invitationals when when they existed before, so I don't really know what I'm missing out on, but certainly like the idea of like the combination of Community Cup and Worlds, that would be an incredible event.
Right.
I would love to see that.
And not only that, just having your face on a Magic card.
Yep.
Yeah.
That's got to be pretty sweet.
I'm still hoping that they just give that to Player of the Year. They've turned Rookie of the Year into a real thing now.
Okay.
But Player of the Year doesn't get anything.
So starting next year.
Player of the Year hasn't gotten anything
and then
for a while.
Backdate it.
Nope.
And then backdate it. Well, I already have an invitational card. I don't know if you've seen Snapcaster Mage, but that
is a lot like you. Yeah. I mean, I've been at enough parties where John Finkel pulls out a copy of Shadow Infiltrator and shows to like some girl, hey, this is me. Where, let me tell you, it is a lot of value being able to
that
do that
is
at a party.
Awesome.
Yeah.
This is another one. We were trying to get into a bar once, and Yelgar Wiegersma did not have a driver's license. So he busts out his pro player card and tries to use that as identification to get into a bar. That was awesome. The dude was just like, get the hell out of here. What are you trying here?
I'll sell for pro player cards if we can't get information.
You guys do have pro player cards.
We do, but like they're not the same as the old ones.
Lifetime winnings.
Impacts.
They're not impacts, but other than that.
Like sealed deck? Ooh, I got a Tom Martell.
You can just go around handing one out whenever you see somebody opening a booster pack. It's like, here's your pro player card. It's supposed to be in there.
Hey, look, you're probably going to get one from China Fireball anyways, right?
I mean, maybe. Hopefully.
People just have to request for them. Yeah. So that's number six, Invitationals. Coming in at number five, we have U.S. or Nationals in general. But just Nationals. Now we have the WMCQ. Nationals was way sweeter, I think. I've never played in the WMCQ, but it just seems like a PTQ.
Here in the U.S., I think Nationals makes a lot of sense. I think for other countries, the WMCQ structure might be a lot better.
Right.
But here in the U.S., I think having a Nationals and having that determine the team is just way, way better.
Yeah, for smaller countries where they can just go to all of their WMCQs, they get their Nationals because everybody just drives to the WMCQs and they play in them, and they get just three Nationals or whatever, which is better than just having one. You know, you get more tournaments to play in, spread out over a few weekends. That seems pretty awesome. Yeah, but for the U.S., it doesn't work because you just don't get everybody going to this one big tournament. Instead, you get these small tournaments that just don't, like, they don't feel like a big deal.
Right.
Nationals just felt like a big thing.
Whole
Blood was a big deal.
Regionals were cool. Regionals was awesome. Then making it to Nationals, being part of the national team, like by playing in your U.S. Nationals instead of, all right, I want this PTQ, I'm on the team or whatever. It just seems like
being part of the team is still as
good
as it ever
was. But it just seems like the tournament itself.
Yeah, the tournament. The WMCQs are not
being a national champion. Feels pretty good, doesn't it?
It does.
Yeah, I guess being a pro tour champion feels good.
It's pretty nice.
I can even speak to both perspectives. You know, I was an old school national champion and also a new school one. The new school one is just way less meaningful.
Exactly.
You gotta get it.
Yeah. They just playing in the big tournament. It's just another big tournament that existed, and it's just not there anymore.
You know?
And
I would love to see that come back. As an asterisk, just my personal wish list related to this. If anyone knows of a small country, maybe like in Eastern Europe, that's giving out citizenships. I'll also take that.
That's what we like to call the Go Dennis Gambit.
Go Dennis, at least he was born there. His family lives there. Go Dennis has a legitimate claim, but there are other ones that are far less legitimate.
I know Antonino did some Italian stuff. I guess he was born in Italy as well.
He is Italian,
but he can play in either.
I mean, Go used to fly back and play in the Lithuanian when it was regionals, and he would play in their national championship, not the U.S. one.
Okay.
So he legitimately has, like, ties there.
Yeah, I mean, I'm assuming the field was a little softer.
Sure.
But, yeah, you're still flying to...
He's part of the community there. There are other ones that are more speculative, and I'm willing to be one of the more speculative ones.
Right.
I'll accept, like, you know, I guess Slovakian is really good. But random...
Yeah, I would love to play in a Korean Nationals, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, there's actually a few good Korean Magic players now. We have Nam Sung-wook and... well, I just said it like such a white person. I should have been like... Nam Sung Wook, but okay, anyways. And Jin Young Park or something?
There's
the guy who won the GP with Scapeshift. I know he's also a Korean guy. But anyways, that's what we want. Number five, Nationals. Coming in at number four, we have a Magic 2016 wish list. So this is going to be the last core set available ever. And what are cards that you kind of are hoping to see out of M16?
That they think are practical or that would have like some nice core set nostalgia?
Just anything. Anything with regards to cores, dual lands.
Sarah Angel and Sanguine Vampire, they should come back for their final appearance. I mean, they've been such staples of core sets throughout the years.
Royal Assassin.
Birds of Paradise.
Birds. I think do all the hits that
birds.
In,
you think birds are gonna?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh. I'd be surprised if birds aren't in it. Like that's it's got it's
standard legal
like,
birds.
Yeah.
I think go back and all the ones that have been like the face of corsets over the years. You can bring back in, you know, the Painlands that are the allied color ones, because those have been in a
I
lot of corsets.
That. Yeah. Well, because we have the enemy ones
right.
and the last ones.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So I think they'll bring those. Well,
at this point, the Glacial Fortress cycle may be more, you know, tied to corsets than those.
I like, I mean, for me personally, the idea of more nostalgia than that, so I
yeah,
like
yeah.
further back.
I would rather go out with a bang and have Painlands as opposed to those.
Wrath of God.
Yes.
Wrath of God. Not Day of Judgment. Wrath of God.
Bring all old ones. It's
tough for it to actually be Wrath of God instead of Day of Judgment.
Oh, is Wrath not modern legal right now?
No, it is. It is.
So I think, I mean, making Wrath be a standard legal card for 2 years or not even that long,
it's
not
like
a big deal.
Yeah. Wrath isn't that bad.
All right.
Yeah.
It should be Wrath.
Although they've moved away from 4-mana Wrath, so that we'll see. I think it's going to be hard to stomach like that. But
they moved away from it, and they're going to move back to it at some point. Like, that's just what they do. Like, they want to...
What do you think about a card like Icy Manipulator?
Terror?
Is Icy Manipulator too good? It wouldn't be good in standard, right?
What?
It'd be unplayable.
No,
is
not
it
in standard.
What do you mean it's too good?
Icy Manipulator was the best card in, like, M11 Limited or whatever.
Was it in M11? I thought it was
it was like 10th edition.
It was like 10th edition.
Okay.
But it was Loxana Warhammer.
It was the second best card because Lux did in Warhammer.
Oh, right.
Card.
It was Loxana Warhammer.
Warhammer.
It was Loxana Warhammer and Icy Manipulator. It was like artifacts were awesome. Yeah.
So we can bring Icy. I mean, Icy is like, you know, obviously an iconic card from Alpha. You know, it was like a chase card back in the day.
Sure.
Royal Assassin.
This has been an uncommon.
The first time I
seem like
the first time I ever played Magic, it was. My computer science teacher in middle
Shivan
school.
Dragon. Yeah, Shivan Dragon. Shivan Dragon
needs to be there. Oh, yeah, Shivan Dragon.
Yeah, Shivan Dragon has to be there.
So a lot of sweet cards. But basically what we want to see is we don't want to see new stuff. We just want to see a lot of cool old stuff being reprinted as kind of a farewell. You know, you know what I mean?
The greatest hits of corsets.
What
Do you think they're, what about the Planeswalkers? Do you think they're just going to go like lower in old school Planeswalkers or Elspeth? Return of Elspeth?
None. If they just did no Planeswalkers, they won't obviously.
No.
So
they're
going to
have Planeswalkers.
Yeah. But I personally would love it if they just.
For Elise, maybe they'll just put them in right there. Maybe it should be too good in standard, though. Actually, I don't know.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Yeah.
They want Baneslayer.
Baneslayer
Angel?
No, too good.
Too good.
Sarah Angel.
No, Baneslayer would not be too good. Baneslayer in current standard would not actually be good at all.
It attacks through Hornet Queen.
Yeah.
Well, it attacks through 2 and 3 of the tokens. I guess the fourth one
gets you. Yeah.
yeah. It's like, God, I just killed all these bees, but there was just one left, and it just stung me, and I died.
Yeah.
All right. So that's number 4, M16 wish list. Coming in at number 3. And this is a set that is generating a little bit more buzz than M16, despite M16.
Slightly more exciting.
And that is, of course, Modern Masters 2015, I believe that's what it's called. Yeah. So that means
there'll be more to come. Moving to the numbering with the
years. You think there's going to be one every year? Like, is it going to replace the core set? Or is that?
I mean, it's not. It's not
going
to replace the core set in that it's not going to be like a major set release.
Right, but is it going to be the summer release?
It could be. Like, if they keep staying as popular as the first Modern Masters was, I think that seems likely.
At some point, though, you feel like it has to get less popular,
right? Once they've made all the expensive cards not absurdly expensive anymore, they can't just do it every year forever. I don't think
they're pretty Vendilion clicking every single one,
I mean, until it gets to like a reasonable price tag, probably. Yeah.
But like, they can just make it like, you know, not only the reason why, I mean, Modern Masters was also just insanely fun to draft, it was very, very
that
awesome.
Draft
limited format
was so good.
So, if Modern Masters 2015 lives up to that, you know. If they just continue, because the thing is, you have this huge pool of cards to work with. You know what I mean?
Yep.
You're not just pigeonholed into like, all right, we got to make sure we use this one mechanic because it's the new mechanic, and we got to make sure everybody has, you know, the morph or everything has this. It's, you have access to like so many different cards, and that's why these sets have been so popular. That's why Vintage Masters was so successful, is because you can just be like, all right, what was sweet? All right, let's put all these sweet things and put it into a set. And they can just keep doing it. So maybe as long as they're just really, really smart about making sure that it's awesome to draft.
Yeah, I mean, they can definitely keep creating an awesome draft format every year. Because,
like you said, they
just have so many cards to pull from. Like,
right.
Yeah,
being able to relive like all of the like greatest themes and decks
from Magic's past in
draft is really cool.
Yeah. Do you think they'll go like goblins and like have Sparksmith in there?
No, but I think
Sparksmith.
I mean,
but you go
maybe at a rare.
No, you go
you could do that. Sparksmith at rare.
Merfolk or Fairies from Lauren Block, right? The, in draft were both awesome. You bring like those back as like so.
Well, Fairies already was in Modern Masters.
Sure.
So, maybe Merfolk, they'll bring Merfolk, like other, goblins, like, yeah. elves. You know, yeah. you can do all kinds of stuff. So, but now we're looking at the wish list for this coming up set. What kind of do you want to see that maybe wasn't in Modern Masters, or what do you kind of want to see again?
So the top of my list is Remand and Serum Visions.
Raptor just going with the most practical,
yeah.
practical cards, not well, not ridiculous. The Chase see, Mythics. We're going with
two probably, right? I assume that one's also expensive.
No,
that
it's
one's
not.
Been printed a ton. Yeah, yeah. yeah, that one's not bad.
But
yeah,
Serum Visions is like an $8, $10 card.
Yeah, for yeah. a common card, that's ridiculous.
It is sweet though. But,
yeah.
yeah,
but you know, these are just like staple cards that everyone should have access to. Like getting priced out of these cards is just ridiculous.
Yeah, it's the whole idea of Modern Masters is to lower the cost and make it so that people can get into playing Modern. You know, when you're getting into Modern, you're like, all right, I want to play this Ascendancy. Why is this common $10? Can you somebody yeah. please tell me? And so that seems like a perfectly fine card
yep.
to print. It wasn't overpowered and limited by any means. So you can print that. And Remand is also a good one. What about rares? Mythics?
I want to see the new Manlands. The Celestial Colonnade.
The Zendikar lands.
Yeah, I'd like to see those guys come back. Now, I'm not sure.
The Zendikar lands, I think people are going to think fetch lands before Manlands.
Oh, sure. Sorry. The Zendikar Manlands. But we might get those when we return to Zendikar.
Sure.
Well, no, then we're going to get the enemy color ones, right?
I like it.
Yeah.
Raptor, yeah. enemy color Manlands.
Those are on my wish list.
That's what happens when we return
not
to Zendikar.
Not for Modern Masters, but not those are on my wish list for
things that I was thinking, filter lands.
Sure.
That could be the cycle of lands that they make. Yeah, the filter lands, because they're very expensive. And also, Fulminator Mage is a card that is like was almost $40, $50. Maybe it's gone down a little bit because nobody plays it anymore. But Fulminator Mage, and also I think, despite it not being a viable deck, Bitter Blossom mm-hmm. could potentially make a yep. comeback.
That was the big one that everyone expected last year, right? And the price tanked, and then it didn't, and its price got up again.
And now it's unplayable, so it's...
Yeah.
Yeah. Man, Bitter Blossom, just the peaks and the valleys. I mean, it was the best card in Standard
for
2 years.
Entire life of Standard. Yeah.
It was insane. All right, so coming... That was number three, Modern Masters. Coming in at number two... So, you know, as we had in our honorable mentions, we had the banning and unbanning of Treasure Cruise. This is now, because Treasure Cruise and all that stuff, number two, probably never, ever going to happen.
I think this will happen at some point.
You think this will happen at some point?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God. Number two, unbanning Jace the Mind Sculptor.
Yes.
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Can we get Channel 5 to make some free Jace t-shirts that we can also wear? Like, with the
He's behind bars?
Yeah, behind bars.
Instead of doing Jace. This, he's like behind bars?
Yeah, I want a free Jace because he's unfairly imprisoned.
Well, Jace is legal. It's just not TMS.
I mean, this is really just tying into three because this is really the number one thing that everyone is wishing for Modern Masters is Jace in it, right?
Can you imagine if they did that? If they timed it with like an unbanning,
yeah.
like, unban Jace the Mind Sculptor
and it's
in Modern Masters.
Yeah. How insane would that be?
But it would be Mythic and Jace would still be insanely expensive.
It would go up in price.
I mean, that's what happened to Tarmogoyf.
Yeah.
yeah.
They're like, all right, sweet Tarmogoyf. Now everybody wants to play Modern. It's $200. Like, I think there's a very good shot because Tarmogoyf is $200 that Tarmogoyf is just going to be reprinted.
Oh, it's for sure in again.
Yeah, right?
No, it's obviously still a mythic rare, but it's going
to
be in again.
But, I mean, I don't think they want a card to cost $200.
No.
So Tarmogoyf, maybe Dark Confidant, and Vendilion Click, cards like that are likely going to be reprinted. That would be my guess. But I don't know.
Yep.
Like, maybe they just make them rare.
They're going to keep them
rare. Wasn't it?
What?
Click, I thought, was rare in Modern
Click,
Masters.
Click, no. and, yeah, no, Click
yeah,
and Confidant.
Was.
No, Click is Mythic.
Was it? Okay.
Yeah, yeah. But in the old sets, obviously, they were all rare. Dark Confidant was also rare.
Yeah, they're all rare.
Well, Mythics didn't exist back then.
Yeah, that's true. But yeah, number two is unbanning Jace. I don't see this. Like, it's got to be like years and years and years from now.
I don't think it's that far. It wouldn't be that good right now.
Yeah.
It really wouldn't.
If it was legal right now, it would barely be playable in Modern.
Yeah, but I mean, I think like all the stuff that happened with Jace in the past is like they're really... I mean,
Jace was never like that big of a problem card in standard. Like Stoneforge Mystic was the problem in the deck, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like Stoneforge Mystic, they can't unban. That card is way too good.
Jace was also the problem.
Yeah, but like, let's be real. Yeah.
Jace was completely broken.
People are going to find a home for Jace.
I mean, we've already talked about
this. This goes hand in hand with a Bloodbraid unban.
Yeah.
Like Bloodbraid is a really good way to keep Jace in check.
Just unban these, and also just don't ban Cruz and
Dig. Don't ban anything else.
You unban Jace. You don't want all those legal.
I think you know what's more likely? You just ban Cruz and whatever and just unban Ancestral Vision.
You can also do that. Yeah. Yeah. I think Ancestral Vision's banned and Cruz is not is laughable.
That
right?
is ridiculous.
If we go back to the previous Modern format with, you know, the new Delve cards banned and Vision legal, like, Vision just is still too good. I don't think you can unban that one.
I love Visions, though.
Yeah, because it's great.
Yeah, it is great.
It is sweet.
Yeah.
No, but I think Jace is definitely unbanned.
So you think
right
they're going to... Do you think... Okay, so...
I've said for a long time that I think Jace is safer to unban than Visions.
All right, here's
a Visions
question,
is better in Modern than Jace.
Here's a question, though. Do you think they're going to unban Jace?
No.
At some point?
Oh, yeah. In the next 10 years, yes.
In the next 2 years?
In the next 2 years, no.
All right.
I think the next 2 years, yes.
We'll see.
Power level keeps going up. Cards are getting better and better. I mean, the cards that were the best cards in
but there's no Planeswalker like Jace.
Sure.
You know, they haven't printed, like, they're being very careful.
Actually, if they're going
modern?
To unban Jace.
But look at the most recent Jace. That thing is.
What Planeswalker sees play in Modern?
Liliana.
Just Liliana, right?
Yeah.
Elspeth, which Karn. Is absurd.
Elspeth and Karn see a lot of play.
A lot of play?
Karn is in Tron.
Karn's like an unplayable deck. It's a fringe deck. It's in one deck.
Yeah.
Right, Elspeth gets played in blue, white, red, and junk. Like, fringe play.
A copy?
Yeah.
Yeah, one or two.
Right. Liliana is...
He gets played in Zoo.
Liliana is the one.
Is the dominant one.
Yes.
Liliana is arguably better than Jace in the format. I think actually is just better than Jace in the format.
It could be.
Right?
And in the current format, I think Liliana is really bad.
What, because they're Treasure Cruise? Discard Treasure Cruise. Yeah,
right.
Once the Delph cards are gone, right? Like, Liliana is on a comparable power level to Jace.
Yeah.
As a magic card. Just the text on the card is comparable.
What about in Cube? Jace.
Jace by a mile, but...
That's like a very, like...
Yeah.
Like, the more creature-heavy the format skews, the better Liliana is and the worse Jace is. So, like, in a format where there's, like, it skews very far away from creatures, like, Cube, like, or especially, Legacy Cube, like, Jace outskills Liliana by a lot. But Modern is extremely creature-based, so Liliana is much closer to Jace in it.
All right. Yeah. So there you have it. Number 2, unbanned Jace. Probably not going to happen, but hey, that's what the point of a wish list is, right?
I'm going to buy a website and get a countdown going.
Oh, God.
Days Chase has been unfairly imprisoned. starting today.
All right, and now we're going to move on to our number 1. And I think this number 1, if it happens, would be pretty sweet. I don't know about you guys, but number 1 is Unified Constructed GPs. Do you think this is going to happen? And if so, what are your thoughts about it?
Definitely going to happen. Maybe not next year, but it's going to happen at some point. Like, Team GPs are awesome. Everybody loves them. I think that there's going to be a lot of demand for constructed GPs that are teams also.
I think you want some form of it. I'm not sure. I think Unified Constructed is, like, a challenging format to administer and for people to get. And, right, it's like, oh, we have to find 3 decks that you can't just, like, net deck them. There'll be some form of a team constructed GP. I agree with that. I'm not sure if this is the right way to do it. But, yeah, something like this.
Yeah, I think it could easily be, like, Standard Modern Legacy also.
Legacy's too hard, I think, to fit in there. It's my guess.
Too hard to fit in there?
It's just like they don't want to promote Legacy to that extent. Like, it's expensive. Like, a lot of groups of teams are going to be priced out. Like, having a Legacy GP means everyone goes and loves Legacy, and you make a group of people super happy. Make a Team GP involve Legacy, you just make a lot of people really disappointed because they really want to play the Team GP.
Right.
And they won't care if they don't play a Legacy GP, but they're like, oh, but I can't play this Team GP.
I think there's more of a team aspect.
You can have the Legacy players find non-Legacy players to team with.
Sure.
To some extent.
But I
don't think that gets ruled out because of Legacy.
I had a lot of fun playing Unified. There was actually one...
I would definitely prefer Unified.
Yeah. There was one PTQ season where it was Unified Standard. And I had a lot of fun. I played in a bunch of them. I traveled. That's one where I went to Phoenix just to play in a team PTQ. And it was awesome. I managed to win one with Luis and Brent Peterson, local here, but we were actually not able to play in the Pro Tour because Luis is a professor would not let him take the final off for whatever reason. But Unified Constructed...
Unsurprisingly, Luis loves that story.
Yeah, of course he does. But yeah, Unified Constructed would be awesome. I'd really love to see it. And it also just fixes, like, the current issue with, limited team GPs is you can't do drafts on day two. It's just not a thing you can do based on the record that you need to top four. There's a lot of collusion that could occur in day two. But with constructed GPs, that doesn't happen. Right. You just keep playing a new team every round. I think it'd be very smooth to run a tournament like that. And I think they should give it a shot. I mean,
as far as the thing with deck lists go, it does have the issue of, you can't necessarily just, like, grab net decks and just easily play in the tournament. But for the people who want to not net deck, it's awesome. Like, you get to do some actual brewing here, which is awesome. And for people who want to net deck, you can still find three just stone net decks and play them. Like, that's just going to work almost every time.
Sure. And there's definitely also, like,
and
hybrid versions.
The big bonus to me, as far as deck lists is concerned, is you get new things happening. Like, you have to go a little bit deeper sometimes when you're building your decks for Unified. So you get, like, some fresh decks, some fresh ideas getting thrown out there. And that translates to people looking at the deck list from this tournament, like, not necessarily to just copy them, but to look at them and be like, oh, that's a really cool idea. Like, you just get more things to stir innovations.
Yeah.
Like, I think that aspect of it is a big argument in favor of Unified.
Yeah. It's definitely one of those things where it's like a mini, you know how like a pro tour, like nobody knows what people are going to do? Like, there's actually room for innovation. You know, Standard gets stale really fast because of all the opens, all the tournaments that happen every weekend. But now you have this tournament where nobody else is actually preparing for it. You could actually, like, do some nifty things.
Yeah, this is like a brand new format.
Exactly.
Like,
Owen Turnwald actually wrote an article for the website where he was like, yeah, we wanted to make a blue-white heroic deck, but we also had another deck that was Jeskai. So they were like, all right, you get two erases, I get two erases, let's split up the flooded. I mean, you have to do some stuff that kind of makes you feel like a team when you're building all the decks together. And I think that's just another thing that is awesome about team tournaments. It's just the camaraderie.
Yep.
And building decks together, awesome. I would really, really want to see this. I don't know if it's going to happen next year, but I think this is something that is very possible. You could get this in the next 2 years.
I think you get some version of it. And maybe it's not that you get four copies of each card, but like maybe no deck can have more than 10 cards total in overlapping with any other deck. So you can do like variations on it.
Sure.
Like, it doesn't have to be necessarily the four of thing, but I think some version of that is a lot of fun. Yeah. It's accessible to everyone. It is the right barrier to entry, but it still has room for innovation. There's a lot of cool.
It could also get tied into either being run like probably right after the World Magic Cup, which uses that format.
Right.
Like making that format have a little bit more relevance could
be
really
awesome.
Interesting.
Yeah, keeping people's interest is important. Like, that was the one problem that I had with Pro Tour Journey into Nyx, where it was block constructed, but there was no relevant tournament about it, so nobody cared about it afterwards.
I mean, that's why they did it with block constructed as a format.
Right.
Block constructed was a sweet format.
But it's just, you have to, if you do that, you have to promote other tournaments like that.
Yeah.
So that was our top 8 wish list for 2015. We have coming in at number 8, Return to Zendikar. Number 7, Moto Fixes, things that we would like to see improved there. Number 6, Invitationals, which would be very, very sweet. Number 5, Nationals. Number 4, Magic 2016 Wishlist, cards that we wanted to see in M16. Number 3, Modern Masters Wishlist, cards that we want to see there. Number 2, the unbanning of Jace the Mind Sculptor. And number 1, Unified Constructed GPs. That was the top 8. I am Paul Cheon, joined here by Josh Utter-Leyton, Tom Martell, and this was Magic TV. Good night, guys.